G'day everyone, Viv here, hope you're all keeping well. Been getting into Flames of War recently. My Force on Force figures, my American 28mm Eureka American Marines, US Marines, and my Afghan figures have disappeared somewhere. I'm not surprised, my garage at home is a filthy mess, so they're probably sitting around somewhere. So when I find those, there's a couple of guys at the club interested in playing some Force on Force. I haven't actually played any games of it, I've just played little scenarios with myself. But I know where my Flames of War stuff is, and there's people here at the club hanging out for Flames of War. So me and Dave managed to play a game on Wednesday, and it was fantastic. First game of Flames of War, probably in, geez, over a year, I reckon. Third Ed came out earlier this year, so we used the Third Ed rules. And it was a great game, had a lot of fun. One, surprisingly. Managed to sneak my Shermans down one of the flanks past some Tigers, lost a few of them on the way, got onto the objective, the Tigers couldn't do anything about them, surprisingly, really ineffective shooting from the Tigers, and took the objective and won. So I thought I'd better start getting some more Flames of War stuff, terrain wise, available for us to play with, because we don't have a lot. We've been primarily 28mm Games Workshop heroic scale scenery around the place, and aside from these buildings which I'd shown in a previous episode, there's not much 15mm terrain around, so I thought I'd sit down and smash out some small hedgerows. These are not bocage, which are much bigger and much wider. They're just little hedgerows based on those wide tongue depressor paddle pop sticks. They're very, very easy to make, and I'm going to show you right now how you can make a ton of them pretty quickly. So this is what we're going to be making, some of these little hedgerows. Again, not bocage, which are much wider and much taller. These are just little hedgerows which our troops can hide behind. And if you see, if I pop this team on the other side of the hedgerow and drop the camera down flat on the table, you can see it's a fairly reasonable height. The figures can still see over them. They get concealment, and they're quick and easy to build. So we'll zip around the table really quickly and I'll show you what I'm using. Basically, there are those wide tongue depressors. I think you can get them at craft stores. I've got a pack of them to use. I made a little jig out of some Lego, which I'll show you what that's used for in just a second. I've got a bunch of mixed clump foliage from lots of different packets. I had some of this left over from when I closed the shop, so I've just kept it. Some dark green and conifer green and all different shades. And basically I'm ripping this all up into small pieces. Some PVA. If you don't have a hot glue gun, I'd recommend using a hot glue gun. It's a lot quicker. PVA is probably neater. Some paint for painting our tongue depressors. This is kind of a reddish brown paint. And that's about it. So there's our materials, let's get into it. Right, so the first step is to take our paint. As I mentioned, this is a reddish brown, more reddish than brown paint. I'd recommend using a brown paint. I just couldn't be bothered fishing through all the paint trying to find it. This was the first one that came to hand, so I'm using it. This little jig that I mentioned before, made out of some Lego. Bit of blue tack on the top. This just allows me to grab one of these toothpicks and then hold it, so I don't have to worry about touching the toothpick. The tongue depressor. And we just go ahead and paint it. All we're looking for is just a flat, even coverage along the top and along the edges here. And really, that's the first step. Paint these. Now, you could use a spray paint or something like that, but it's nighttime, it's cold, and they're just not going to dry fast enough. So, really, that's all we need to do. Once it dries, we'll just give it a second coat, and it's done. So there's the first one. We'll just pop that off, lift that side, and we can just pop it down the table. Next one, put it on the onto my little contraption for holding. And I'm just gonna go ahead now and paint up five or six of these. I think these are 6 inches long. So two of these is a foot. You wanna do one long line across a 4 foot table, you need 8 of them. This part's pretty straightforward. It's pretty quick, it's pretty simple, as are the other parts of this process. Pop that, pop that. So I'm just gonna go ahead and paint up a bunch of these. Now if you wanted to, before you go ahead and paint these, you could always put a layer of PVA on here and add some texture with some sand or something. But since the majority of these sticks here are gonna be covered with the clump foliage, I'm not really worrying too much about the texture. The clump foliage is actually gonna be enough for us to understand and recognize what's going on. Right, that'll be enough. What have we got? 2, 4, 6, 8, we've got 10 of them. 5 feet. 5 foot of some little hedgerows under construction. So let's just clean up our brushes, tidy our workspace. We're gonna wait for these to dry and then we'll come back. Okay, so now that we've got our sticks done, I've given these 2 coats. I've also done a whole bunch of others. Next is our clump foliage. As I mentioned earlier on, I've got a mix of different colors here. Now, you could do this with all the same color, but it looks a little bit more natural when there's various different sorts of colors in there. So you can see this clump foliage is very, very small. Now, if I take some clump foliage out of the pack, normally it's reasonably large. Now with this clump foliage, you want to break it into much, much smaller pieces. And you can just do that by ripping it apart. With that clump foliage prepared, i.e. ripped apart and mixed up in a big pile like I've got here on the table, you want to make sure that you've got a nice hot glue gun or your PVA if you want to use PVA. And we start applying this to our sticks. It's fairly straightforward. All we need to do is, with our hot glue gun, from one side, I like to work from the left-hand side to the right-hand side, or on camera it's in reverse. And I put down about 1.5 inches, all the way from the edge, a reasonably thick line, about 1.5 inches all the way down. Then I take bunches of clump foliage and just press it on top. Squeezing it in from the sides, like I'm pinching it to make sure I get all the way around the hot glue, and continue. And there you go. You've just learned how to make these hedgerows. The rest of it's just applying small parts at a time, doing small little bits of hot glue so it doesn't dry, and then squeezing it in the edges. There we go. The last one. Now the only thing to be aware of here really is to make sure that you go all the way to the end, so that when they butt up against each other, you get an uninterrupted hedge. Simple. So there we go. If you've been watching for a while, then you know I like to do things quick and easy. Let's have a quick look at the results of maybe 15-20 minutes work. I think it's fantastic. Thanks for watching, guys. Catch you next time.